Similarly, in the feedback network, you can calculate the feedback factor Vf by V0 by considering input current 0. So overall summary of this amplifier is, here we can able to calculate the Ri R0 value for the A circuit, as well as RIF and R0F, including resource resistance and load resistance, but actual input and output resistance can be calculated by excluding the source and load resistance, that is RIF equal to Rin plus RS, R0F equal to Rout parallel with RL. This is the example of series and amplifier. In this, you can represent the diagram, equivalent circuit diagram like this, and calculate the beta. Now we are going to see series feedback upgrade. First, we see the ideal value for the circuit. So, this feedback amplifier, otherwise called as transconductance amplifier, that's why we are going to calculate the transconductance gain from the circuit, that is A equal to I0 by VI. See here, the output value in terms of current, the input circuit will be in terms of voltage, that's why we are calculating I0 by VI. So this is the equivalent circuit for the previous circuit. So here beta factor can be calculated as Vf by I0. So this is the practical series feedback amplifier. Here the feedback network is not ideal, and load amplifier is load is included in the basic amplifier, which will affect the gain value, input resistance and output resistance. So here the feedback network is represented by its Z parameter. So in this circuit we are going to neglect the parameter Z21 alone from the feedback network, so that the load effect of the feedback network on the basic amplifier is represented by the Z11 and Z22 parameter. So Z11 is nothing but impedance looking from the port 1 of the feedback network by considering port 2 as open circuit. Similarly, Z22 is the impedance looking from the port 2 of the feedback network by considering port 1 as open circuit. Now we are going to determine the beta value Z12, which is equal to V1 by I2 by considering I1 equal to 0. So here from the A circuit we are going to calculate gain value, that is I0 by VI, similarly beta factor as Vf by I0 by considering IA 0. This is the example of series feedback amplifier, equivalent circuit of the example, so that you can calculate the R0F, Rout value from the example of series feedback. Next, last two types, the shunt and sun series feedback amplifier, can be studied by yourself by noting the value. You have to note very importantly closed loop gain, feedback factor, load effect and its example. So next, the stability problem. So here the closed loop transfer function, which is similar to the one of the middle band gain. So the condition for the negative feedback to oscillate is L of j omega equal to A of j omega into beta of j omega equal to minus 1. Any right half plane poles result in instability. Amplifier with a single pole is unconditionally stable. Amplifier with two poles is also unconditionally stable. Amplifier with more than two poles has the possibility to be unstable. Stability study can be studied using board plot. Gain and phase margin. So the gain margin represents the amount by which the loop gain can be increased while the stability is maintained. Unstable and oscillatory, stable and non-oscillatory, only when the margin phase margin exceeds 45 degree or gain margin exceeds 6 decibel can the amplifier be stable. So this is the stability analysis using board plot of A. Here the gain margin and phase margin can be calculated by considering the horizontal line of inverse of feedback factor in decibel. Here the rule of thumb is the closed loop amplifier will be stable if the 20 log of 1 by beta line intersect with the 20 log of modulus A curve at a point on the 20 decibel per decade segment. The general rule states that at the intersection of 20 log of 1 by beta j omega and 20 log of modulus A of j omega, the difference of slopes should not exceed 20 decibel per. So frequency compensation, the purpose of frequency compensation is to modify the open loop transfer function of the amplifier having three or more poles so that the closed loop amplifier is stable for any desired value of closed loop gain. So the theory of frequency compensation is the enlarging of minus 20 decibel per decade length. Thus here the implementation is using CC capacitance and Miller compensation and pole. So this is the multi-stage two cascaded multi-stage amplifier and its corresponding equivalent circuit. In the corresponding equivalent circuit we are going to include compensating capacitors. So this is the frequency compensation represented for beta equal to 10 power minus 2. Here the response A dash is obtained by adding a pole at FD. Similarly A double dash response is obtained by moving low frequency pole at F dash. So here stage amplifier we are including compensating capacitor in the feedback path and corresponding equivalent circuit.